beautiful vibration, nation to nation, echo proclamations all over brave new world. Hello, this is Kevin Gant. How you doing? I'm the subject of Jay Duplass's documentary entitled Kevin, and it's about when I was a open mic host in Austin, Texas in the early 90s. I stopped performing for 17 years, and I got an email blast from the past from an individual that I didn't know who's now directing feature films in Hollywood. That's Jay Duplass, and thanks to him, he's resurrected my career. I'm touring film festivals all over the United States, and I'm coming to South Alabama, near neck of the woods, on November the 4th at the Space 301 at the theater there at that wonderful venue. I'm going to be performing some of my unique songs from the early 90s. I'm so thankful for your support. Sorry for the quality of the Skype here. I'm in a hotel room in Los Angeles right now in between festivals. I just got back from South Dakota. So I'm going to be touring for a couple of more months, and I love to have y'all come out and support me. I appreciate everyone. All the film audience has been an amazing audience for me, and I've just been spoiled to pieces. So thank you, and I'd like to thank the South Alabama Film Festival for putting this on. It's all run by volunteers, and they do all of this work just for the love of film. I'm so thankful for to be part of the film community. It's a new thing for me, and I will love film for the rest of my life. Thank you for being a wonderful audience, and I hope to see you November the 4th. I appreciate it, okay?
Hi, my name is Jay Duplass, and I'm a filmmaker, and I'm here with my first documentary, Kevin, which is about my childhood hero, sort of college days, fascination with the musician Kevin Gant, who is hands down the most inspired person that I have ever known or met or seen before. In 1995, Kevin completely disappeared, and for 13 or 14 years, I would scour the internet and newspapers looking for any sign of him showing up and playing again, but he never did. And so a couple of years ago, I finally decided to personally go look for him. I found him, and we ended up making this film, and I got to explore who he is, what inspired his creativity, and learned about the really dark things that he's been through that, you know, ultimately stopped him from playing. It culminated in a journey that he and I took that ended up reigniting his dream as well as mine. And it was really a magical experience first and a movie second. So I'm here on Kickstarter today raising money for some typical film things like finishing the color correct, doing a proper sound design, and some finishing funds. But more importantly, we showed a rough cut of this film at South by Southwest, and Kevin came up when the credits ended and played his first show in 15 years, and it was amazing and explosive, and essentially, film festivals have come knocking, and film festivals are literally becoming Kevin's comeback tour. So please support us in putting Kevin back on tour. It will definitely make his dreams come true. And it's been a lifelong dream of mine to help expose the world to Kevin. So thank you so much for your support. And here's a sneak peek at Kevin.
I had heard different things off and on that I was kind of wondering about. Like, for example, when I went to the bridge, I was just in the middle of the day, and all of a sudden I got this burning flash. It wasn't fire, but it was just all of a sudden this sharp image of an old bridge that was way out in some distant ancient rainforest somewhere that was used to get from one side to the other, but it was so old that it was about to, you didn't know whether you could walk on, Indiana Jones kind of thing. And I was like, why would I see a bridge? Why would I'm not watching a movie, I'm not doing anything. I was trying to clean my closet or something, and I see this clear as a sharp crystal, I saw a bridge.
Rain and potholes from the canes have made it all old and rickety. Devoid of shellac with ropes, holding it together loosely.
When I was in Austin performing, I had been successful more and more, you know, as time progressed. So the obsession turned into this thing of me making it. So the logical next step to me was to go to California. And when I got out there, I ran into a brick wall.
Never in my life have I felt closer to death.
When I got back to Texas, I wanted to play, but I couldn't. There was like something inside of me that switched off.
And ultimately, I forgot the dream. When I was young, I decided I needed to find flamenco because I wanted to play guitar good, and they're the best guitarists in the world. And so I was obsessed with the fact that I will go to Spain.
This is the culmination of a dream for me that has its roots in music.
Last night was the first time in years that the song came to me. My muse is awake now, or I'm awake.